Greetings, adventurers. Today's video is sponsored by Metalkitor. They are a metalworking company that creates beautiful, handcrafted, and very intricate designs of decorative pieces, as well as functional art, and really beautiful journals as well. So they sell both fully made pieces, as well as model kits that you can buy and build yourself. So they sent me a really, really beautiful gift set of a steampunk-inspired journal. The journal is really beautifully designed with lots of intricate details. And the set that they sent me came with a quill and a stand, as well as sealing wax and a stamp, so you can seal your own letters and style. Many of their designs are heavily inspired by steampunk, which if you've been on this channel for any amount of time, you know that I love steampunk. So their stuff is really, really cool. So you'll get to see more of the journal in this video, as well as the quill and all the other pieces as well. And I would encourage you to check them out. They are a really, really cool company. And if you do end up purchasing anything, we have a special exclusive discount code. You can enter the code WA12 to receive 12% off at their shop. So I will leave that on the screen and then also in the description as well. So thank you so much to Metalkitor for sponsoring this video. Thank you for watching. Oh, hello. Are you all finished up tidying up in the back? Good, good, good. Well, don't worry about all this stuff. I'll take care of some of it and we can take care of the rest of it in the morning. It's been quite a busy day here, hasn't it? Not that there's anything wrong with that when you're running a shop. Busy days are good days. But it can lead to quite a bit of mess. We'll finish up in the morning, all right? Thank you for taking care of the storage in the back. You can go ahead and head out. Oh, this? Well, this is not strictly shop-related, I suppose. I was just taking some time to answer some of the letters that we receive. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, we get letters almost every day here. Mostly from people asking questions or sharing different ideas that they have. It's quite wonderful. And most of them are from children. So I like to just take some time at the end of the day to respond to some of the letters and send them back. Mm-hmm. Oh, well, no, I suppose it's not strictly necessary, but we do work in a toy shop, darling. Technically, nothing that we do is necessary to, you know, in the grand scheme of things. There are lots of people who would say that a shop like this and an inventor specializing in toys and fun little gadgets is not necessary either. But I tend to disagree. You see, of course, people who invent all of these useful things, these functional gadgets and things like that, of course that's very important. But you know what else is important? Imagination. Creativity. Wonder. And I think that's something that is very important, especially when it comes to children. There's something that we lose when we grow up. Some people like to call it childhood innocence, but I don't think that that really encompasses it. I think that it's a sense of fearlessness. When we grow up, we become afraid. Afraid of mistakes, afraid of failures, afraid of people telling us that something is impossible. But oftentimes children, they don't accept the word impossible. They may understand what it means, of course. But all that impossible means is that no one has done it yet. There are so many things that we take for granted every day that at some point in history was impossible. And all it took was someone believing that it didn't have to be that way. All it took was someone wondering. Childhood wonder is one of the most powerful forces in this whole world. So, I enjoy taking some time, even at the end of a long day when I may be quite tired. I think it's still very important to answer these children and to let them wonder, help them keep imagining. Anyway, that's just something that I like to do. You're welcome to go home. I don't think that there's anything else that needs to happen. I'll lock up when you're finished. Oh, you want to? Of course you can read them. I would love for you to read some. You know, it's incredible. Sometimes these children send me letters and they're asking questions and they want to learn something. But so often, I end up learning something from them. Every day. And sometimes all it takes is just thinking about something in a different way. Children are wonderful at that too. Sure, yes, please go ahead and take some of these letters. Now, my one rule is that you are not dismissive about anything, okay? That there may be questions in here or different ideas that you might read and say, oh, well, that's not possible. But to a child's mind, it very well could be. And maybe someday it won't be impossible. The worst thing that you could do to a child is dismiss them when they've asked a genuine question. We grown-ups like to think that we know everything, but oftentimes we really don't. We think that we do. There's quite a lot to learn from children too. So if you would like to help answer some of these letters, that would be wonderful. Of course, if you have any questions about anything, feel free to ask, but yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. You might just learn something too. Sure, yeah, why don't you start with this one? You see what they have to say. Okay, let's see, where was I? Yeah. Isabel. Yeah. Are you all finished too? Wonderful. Well, thank you for your help. That certainly went quite a lot faster than it normally does. I hope that you learned something getting to read through some of those letters today. Good. There is no room for boring grown-ups in a shop like this. And no room for the word impossible either. Impossible simply means that it hasn't been done yet. And who knows, maybe some of those children that you got to write to today, maybe they'll be the next generation's great inventors. You never know. Anyway, now it really is getting quite late, isn't it? You'd better find your way home. Okay, yeah, you can go ahead and leave them there. I'll put them all on the post tomorrow so that the children know that we're listening. Thank you for your help today.